Κατρίν, ευχαριστούμε που ήρθες. Ήθελα να ρωτήσω σχετικά με το δημόσιο χρέος της Ισλανδίας, το οποίο αρνηθήκατε να πληρώσετε και καλά κάνατε, κατά την άποψή μου, γιατί ήταν παράνομο. Ένα παρόμοιο πρόβλημα αντιμετωπίζουμε κι εμείς. Ποιες ήταν οι απειλές οι οποίες ακούστηκαν σχετικά με το δημόσιο χρέος, δηλαδή ότι πρέπει να το πληρώσετε, και τι τελικά συνέβη, δηλαδή υπήρχαν συνέπειες, υπήρξε κάποια έλλειψη σε εμπορεύματα, υπάρχουν κάποιες χώρες οι οποίες δεν κάνουν εισαγωγές, εξαγωγές με την Ισλανδία ακόμα. Αυτά.
What we were dealing with was Britain and Holland putting a terrorist legal action against Icelandic banks. It was a really serious situation. Icelandic banks had been layering in a terrorist way after, you know, maybe. But in a way that it was like it was an insult, and it was a whole massive sort of really, it was like a war on Iceland, and Iceland is tiny. I mean, if you want to cross off Iceland, you can do it in 1 second if you're in Great Britain. And then what happened was that our Prime Minister at the time said, oh, they're never going to make us pay anything we're not supposed to pay. But then the whole European Union started to join them. And we were faced with the whole European Union saying, you're not getting any loans, just like your same argument you're getting now. Your credibility is going to be crap. You're never going to be able to do anything again. You know? And this scare tactics is what the system uses over and over again to try to force people into doing something that might not be fair or right at all. Yeah? And that's only because it suits the system. And why in the world are we still listening to Moody's, for example? All they have done is prove that they're always wrong. And they're still able to control the market. I mean, it's so unbelievably stupid. So in a way, what happened was that the politicians said, okay, actually we must pay. We're very sorry, but we've gone to the UK and everybody's really angry. And they want their money back. So here's a contract that we need to sign and we need to pay them back. And this contract was basically Iceland pays everything. The UK and Holland, who also had the stupid European rules of monetary system, pay nothing. You know, just because we're the smallest one. A little bit like you're having now. And the parliamentarians, they did not have the guts to say no to this because they are part of the system. And they said, okay. And then the president stepped in at the crucial point, because he has in the old constitution or current constitution, he has a chance to say, okay, I will not sign this legal act, therefore it does not become binding, I will give it to the League. And then there's a referendum. And this had only been used, I think, either once or never before, you know. And the people went there and 98% said no. This is a bad contract, we're not gonna take it, this is the, you know, fuck off, and we'll just die here alone in the middle of the Atlantic Ocean, we can eat fish, you know. I'm just saying that this was the attitude in Iceland, you know, you put terrorist act on us, and then you tell us to pay something that is equally your fault. You should have warned your citizens that this was a crack back. It's not our fault only, you know. And then they came back and they said, oh, we've got a new contract, much better one. Do you want to sign that one? And the president said no, because a lot of people had been asking him to say no, because we wanted to vote again. And this contract was much better. Imagine, just because the people said no to the first contract, and there you go, Mr. Plebison, we would have had that contract if we didn't have the national referendum. Then we got a much better contract. So it does work sometimes. The next contract, it was much closer. It was like 54% said no to that because people saw it was a better contract. Again, people are not stupid. Some of them just wanted to pay it off and get rid of it. And we are not off the hook. Now they're going to go to the courts and try to get us there. So maybe our debt would be even greater. We don't know what the consequences are, but at least we got the chance to call it over ourselves, you know? Say if we get massive debts, it's our own fault. It's not the fault of some politicians far away who drive fancy cars and we don't even know. It's our own fault. And it's a really big responsibility for us to have as a nation, and it's where the responsibility should lie, you know? So that's the consequence.
ακόμη θα θέλαμε να ευχαριστήσουμε το ηλεκτρονικό περιοδικό Αντίφωνο με τις προσπάθειες του οποίου θα βιντεοσκοπηθεί και θα αναρτηθεί στο διαδίκτυο σημερινή εκδήλωση και το περιοδικό Αντίφωνο είναι χορηγός αυτής της εκδήλωσης και το ευχαριστούμε πάρα πολύ γι' αυτό.